Hey guys, how you doing? So today I'm going to teach you guys how to do the mousetrap. It's been a while that I've been wanting to do these type of videos. Now that we're all quarantined, I'm able to take a step back from the rat race and actually focus on a little bit passions of mine. The mousetrap was created by the godfather of street soccer, Eddie Van Gill. Crazy inspiration. He inspired me from kind of getting away from regular soccer on the grass more into street, and now that's all I play is just street soccer. So let's get to it.
For this tutorial, it's very important that you stretch. This is a futsal ball. Notice how it doesn't bounce as much as a soccer ball does. So this is perfect for futsal, street soccer. It's pretty much, it keeps it dense so the ball doesn't really jump and bounce. So first step, what we're going to do, we're going to get the ball with our weak foot and we're going to roll it alongside us, not at us, but alongside. So ready? Look like this. Then you're going to want to continue to do this and be repetitive on this. Use that same foot and roll it alongside. So second step of the mouse trap, you're going to want to let the ball roll, get your strong foot and go over the ball like this and touch the ground. This is what's important to make the mouse trap work, because you're going to want to pretend like you didn't get the ball. And just continue it. So just roll the ball back, go over it, and then try to reach for the ball. It's really simple once you keep doing it. Just always practice. Just roll the ball, go over it, and then stop it. Easy. Try it again. Ready? Roll the ball, go over it, and stop. So once you get this down, you're going to be able to do the mouse trap. You're going to always want to pretend like you missed the ball and grab it. So for the bonus trick, you're going to want to get the ball with your weak leg and roll it across from you. While you're doing that, get your strong foot and stop the ball. You're going to want to try that over and over. It seems easy, but it's a little bit harder. While you're doing that, you're going to want to tie your shoes while the ball rolls and stop it. For the first variation, you're going to want to spread your legs out a little bit farther so you'll be able to grab the ball while you tie your shoes at the same time. Just spread your legs out, don't have them too close. Now the second variation, you're going to want to put your feet together and then go for the ball while you tie your shoes. It's a little bit harder, but once you practice, you got it. Last tip, you're going to want to be able to bend your knees while you're doing the trick. It makes it a whole lot easier to grab the ball while you tie your shoes, or pretend to tie your shoes. And just practice. You're not gonna get it right away, but just continue to do this, variations of it, and you'll be able to get it. Now this is when you put it in the combo.